getting ready. I think it was all very chilled.
Beautiful sunny day, and I just thought it's a perfect day for a wedding.
We were very organised. Everybody was ready on time, but then it got to about 11 o'clock. Paula turned up with my dad.
Relaxed there, everything seemed to be going smoothly.
And everything got started to get a bit more manic.
People trying dresses on, getting their makeup done, having their hair done. We don't see her all the time, so having that time with her was really, really good. And with her friends, it was really special, actually.
Maybe a little bit stressed. I just wanted everyone to be ready. But when I got it on and I came downstairs and everybody just looked really happy, I just felt really excited more than anything. I didn't really feel nervous. I just wanted to get to the church. Didn't want to hang around anymore.
Lisa and I sat in the back of the car and travelled to the church.
We kept getting beeped by cars as they went past when they saw that they were bridal cars.
Kieran got up and he made tea for everybody.
I think I was bouncing off the walls a bit overexcited. My dad made us all breakfast. To calm us down, he made us take the dog out for a walk. Helped me, a few final thoughts, clear my head a little bit.
We all got ready, and I've got to say, it made me really proud.
But we still got to the church.
Kieran took Harrison, who's absolutely idolises him.
About an hour and a half early, made me a little bit more nervous, more than anything. Just sort of standing around as people arrive in and seeing how excited everyone was. I just wanted Lisa to hurry up and get there, just so we could sort of crack on with it.
Well, they're 20 minutes early.
So I had to drive around, up and down, while everybody else still arrived.
Which just made me more nervous.
Off we went, into the church together.
Well, when we were waiting to go in, I got really nervous. Dad just said to me, stop getting nervous. And I think I had to take a couple of deep breaths as I walked down the aisle. But I think when Kieran turned round, then I was okay. Just felt really happy.
Proud of her, she looked great.
Lisa walking up the aisle to the music, looking absolutely radiant.
I had a sneaky look, but she just looked amazing. So happy.
Angela and I lit a candle for our two children.
Lisa, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I on E.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Two are better than one. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up.
I like you because I don't know why, but everything that happens is nicer with you.
I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife.
Lisa looks stunning and is a beautiful bride. Knowing how exacting Lisa's tastes are, I find it hard to believe that she found someone perfect enough for her and willing to keep her in the lifestyle she's used to.
Thank you for agreeing to marry me and making me the happiest guy in the world. Thank you for your efforts in coordinating our big day. And I'm sure you all agree how stunning Lisa looks today, and nothing could prepare me for what I saw when she walked down that aisle.
We used to go on holiday together, and Lisa, being an only child, had to choose only one friend to go on holiday with her, and she chose me. Repeatedly.
Actually, speaking of holidays, remember turkey and the fish bowls?
We love you both.
We love you both.
Cheers. Love you. I love you more.
He has since grown to a true gentleman with a footless haircut and questionable t-shirts, which he shares with his younger brother, Harrison.
Kieran has watched High School The Musical 94 times and still cries at the end.
To the new Mr. and Mrs. Brenchley, we wish them well for the future and a long and happy marriage.
I'm very, very proud of you.
I really do wish them all the love in the world.
I know they will be happy. They're just meant for each other.
Stay the same as you've been and just carry on living life to the full.
I just love Lisa an unbelievable amount. She probably never realised. She's just the best thing in the world, really.
How long will I love you? As long as stars are above you.
Love you so much, and I'm so pleased to be your wife. Can't wait to get back to normal and be married and just enjoy that.